I'm the calculus professor, and today we'll be talking about U substitution. Welcome back. Today we'll be talking about section 5.5, substitution rule. And we're going to start with problem number 17. And in problem 17, we want to use substitution to integrate the following. So this is the integral of 2x times x squared minus 1 to the 99th power dx. All right, so obviously the first thing that we could do, which would be extremely painful, is we could take this thing and we could multiply it out to the 99th power, multiply all that out, and then integrate. Well, of course, that seems rather unpractical. So we'd like another way to do a problem like this. And the way that we do this is we call it substitution, and sometimes we call it U substitution, because the letter that we use typically for this substitution is the letter U. Okay, and what we're going to do is we want to change all of these x's that we have in this problem into a different variable U, and hopefully by doing so, we make it so that we can easily integrate this thing, where right now it's a little bit difficult to integrate this thing. So let's try it. So what I'm going to do is I'm looking for a piece of this integral that if I take the derivative of it, it also shows up in the integral. So for example, in this case, I have x squared minus 1. And x squared minus 1, if I take its derivative, it would be 2x, and that also shows up. So that's a clue for me that that might be the right thing to substitute for. Now, when you're doing U substitution, sometimes you make a substitution and it's the right one. Sometimes you make a substitution, it might be the wrong one and you have to try something else. That's okay. Just keep trying different substitutions until you can rewrite this thing in a form where you can take an antiderivative. Okay, so what we're going to try here is I'm going to make a substitution. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say, let's let u be equal to x squared minus 1. And the reason I choose x squared minus 1, well, really two reasons. First, because I see what its derivative is, that it's 2x, and I have a 2x sitting out here. But the second reason is that it's a function inside of another function. So I'm also looking for things that are functions inside of functions, and those are typically the things that we make a U substitution for. Now that we've got our U, then we can say, okay, if U is this, then what is du? And du is going to be the derivative of this guy with respect to x, which in this case is 2x, but we have to add on a dx. If you don't really like what I wrote right here, yeah, another way of thinking about this is that du dx is equal to 2x. So now if I just multiply both sides by dx, I would get that du is 2x dx. But typically we skip this step, and we just go straight to this step and write that du is equal to 2x dx. All right, so now that we know that du is equal to 2x dx, I look back over here, and I see that, okay, this thing I'm going to end up rewriting as u. Let me show you what I mean. I'll underline this, and I'll underline this. Notice that x squared minus 1, that's just u. So I could replace this guy with u. Also, I have 2x dx. Now, they're not written exactly right next to each other, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be written right next to each other as long as everything's multiplied together. So I have a 2x times a dx, and I know that 2x times a dx can be written as a du. So 2x dx, I'm going to rewrite that as du. So let's do it. So this is the same thing as the integral of, I've got u remember x squared minus 1, that's u to the 99th power. And then 2x dx is du. So another way of writing this integral is using a u substitution, we could write it as the integral of u to the 99th du. But of course, that's a simple integral, and we can do it quickly. So we need the antiderivative of u to the 99th, but of course that is u to the 100th divided by 100 plus our constant of integration. Okay, and we have now taken an antiderivative, but we are not done. And the reason that we're not done is because we still have a u sitting here in our problem. So how do we deal with that u? Well, we need to say, well, what is u? U is x squared minus 1. So I can replace this u with an x squared minus 1, and I would be done. So I can rewrite this one more time. This is equal to u, which is x squared minus 1, to the 100th power, divided by 100, plus c. And we have our answer. Now, if you ever get to this point and you say, I don't know, I don't think I got the right answer, I may have made a mistake, I'm not really confident, what you could do is just take the derivative of this thing. And if you take the derivative of this thing, you better get what you started with. So you can always check your work on these just by taking a derivative. So here is our antiderivative for this integral.